Anita. We'll now start the meeting. Well, welcome to the cabinet meeting today, Monday the 20th of January. Before we start, I'm going to ask everybody to stand for a minute of silence. Okay, straight on to the agenda. Members' code of conduct, declarations of interest. Are there any declarations of interest from anybody? No? Okay, thank you. Okay, minutes of the last meeting have been printed and published. Okay, by Simon. Decisions under delegated powers. These are key decisions taken from the 13th of December to today. There's three town centre retail warehouse, one on 127th floor of the road there ahead. The fair development option for the new ferry and Wirral Council to commit to keep it. These are just for noting. Can we note them, cabinet? Thank you very much. Okay, item number four on the agenda, site of the former Rockferry High School sale to a registered provider in the hard copies, pages 1-6. Councillor Janette, would you please introduce this report? Thank you, Janette.
Thanks, Pat. It's really nice to have a little new story to take to cabinet today. This is around the site of the former Rockferry High School and its sale to a registered provider, which is Taurus. Improving housing availability for residents is a key priority for Wirral, enabling regenerative projects that also support our local planning process, so ideal for the area, our green spaces, residents and future homeowners. So this particular site will allow the providers to develop affordable housing, bringing much needed added social value to the area as they repurpose the space to benefit the community. As part of an extra case housing scheme supported by funding from Homes England, the development will see up to 86 shared ownership and affordable rent residential units, including houses, bungalows and apartments created on the site. Of these, more than 100 will be extra care units. Taurus, as the registered provider, have been selected to develop the site and they work with the Council's Housing and Investment Team to agree the scheme. They've calculated a land value of £2,100,000 to deliver the specific scheme. In respect of social value and community wealth building, Taurus have suggested the following, that they're committed to building affordable homes of the highest standards, which I think is really, really important. We have to agree that quality of housing is as important as affordability going forward as a council. They're going to build modern sustainable homes which are energy efficient and well located to meet local housing needs. Taurus actively invest initiatives to support tenants and communities, address deprivation and promote inclusion. They're bringing a derelict Grade 2 listed building back into use for affordable housing. They're maximising and enhancing the wooded area to open up to public access. Four of the extra care apartments have been designed for wheelchair users, and all of the 10 bungalows have been designed to be accessible and adaptable for tenants' future disability requirements. housing needs, Wirral will also benefit from capital receipts resulting from the sale of the land, and obviously ongoing receipts coming in from council tax as well. A portion of which will be, which will help to pay for the improvements on Riverside Primary School, which I think we can all agree that this development, this proposed development, is probably a win-win all round, really, for us. We've got our affordable houses there, we've got extra support, extra care houses, and we've also worked with the residents really closely to arrive at this. So I'm really, really happy to recommend this to Cabinet. I think it's a great news story. It crossed over so many portfolios of my colleagues here today, and it gives us a real chance to push forward affordable housing, community wealth building, and close sort of working with residents, so we can say that we're delivering on what their priorities are as well as the councils. So I recommend this. Thank you, Pat.
Thank you, Councillor Williamson. Councillor Chris Jones.
Thank you, Pat. I'd like to absolutely support this. The 102 extra care units are so important. We know it's part of the key priority for Wirral's housing strategy. But what it really does is enable people to stay as independent as they can be and stay in their own homes instead of having to access residential or nursing care. So I'm really delighted with this.
Councillor Tony Jones.
Thanks, Pat. Yeah, this is, as your colleague said, it's a classic example of a cross-cutting development that touches on so many portfolios sat around this table. You know, the numbers are first class, and it's gratifying to hear that they're going to be high quality as well as affordable. It's much needed accommodation. It's much needed accommodation that is disabled friendly. And I would have no hesitation at all in fully endorsing and supporting. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Tony. Councillor Liz Grey.
Thank you. I think this is a great opportunity. I'm really pleased with it. I know the plans predate the climate emergency, so I would welcome the chance to work with developers to ensure that we maximise all environmental protections and we meet our climate targets with good high quality housing. Thank you.
Thank you, Liz. Councillor Stuart, Whittingham.
Thanks, Chair. It's really good to see and I very much welcome the provision of affordable loans at this scale, which we all know is much needed. And also, in particular, the extra care scheme. And I think more of a byproduct of extra care as well as the high quality provision for a number of people who need that extra support is the back the effect that providing more extra care that feeds up more family rooms that can be fed into the housing market and help people get onto the property ladder and secure accommodation that is desperately needed in this area. Which is welcome, of course.
Thanks for the Councillor Tom Usher.
Thanks, Chair. I think obviously one of our major priorities as an administration is to build a borough that lends itself to affluent and prosperous communities and that doesn't fall into many of the contributing factors of poverty and employment opportunities and affordable housing are absolutely two key pieces of the puzzle there. Speak to a lot of young families in my hometown of Wallasey and you know the information that I get off them is similar to you know young people and young families across the borough, which is that they struggle to get on both the career and the housing ladder. I myself, I'm only 26, and I'm yet to buy. So it's a real and palpable struggle. The fact that we've had 10 years of increasing pressures on families and a stagnation of standards of living is no doubt one of the causing factors of a doubling of the number of children in care over the same period of time, over a decade. And one of those key pressures is without financial pressure. So I think this council is absolutely putting its money where its mouth is and ensuring that a developer, it's financially feasible for a developer to deliver something that is in line with all of our social value priorities. Thanks, Chair.
Thanks, Tom. Councillor Jeremy Leech. Sorry about that. Leech.
Thanks, Chair. I also support this application. I think it's a good use of an old site. It's good to see improvements to the Riverside Primary School, and it's absolutely in line with the mixed tenure, which is in line with the local plan for this particular area.
Now, Councillor.
Thanks, Pat. I just want to thank my colleagues for all their positive input here. And I think it's really important going forward that developers who plan to work with us as a council take this on board, that we want to see developers in our key to push forward our agenda that we've set, which is a green agenda, which incorporates community wealth building, which is very much community-led. So this is a great opportunity to show what we can do when we put our priorities forward as a Labour Council, and what we can achieve when we have developers who are also committed to dealing with that vision as well. Thank you very much, everyone.
Okay, thanks, Cabinet Members. Thanks for those comments. I take it you're proposing the recommendations, Janette?
Yes, Chair.
Can we second that?
Second.
Can we agree? Any against? No abstentions. Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay,
the last one is the Audit and Risk Management Committee annual report that comes annually, obviously, to Cabinet. Don't intend to debate this one, just having duly considered it, I'll ask Cabinet members to note